Sister Erica Liburd and Brother Dave McLaughlin for that meditative selection of the Lord's Prayer. Peace and blessings, family. Truly, we have come this far by faith, leaning on the Lord. And what a momentous occasion it is, Mother's Day. I am giving honor to my dear mother, Helen Davis, and all of the mothers of the church that have raised me, the sisters, the aunties, the friends. Thank you so much for your love. At this time, I'd like to share a piece and dedicate it to all of you, all of the nurturing figures in my life and those that have raised me to this place today. Also in honor of my dear, dear godmother, Francina Hill, who transitioned a few years ago in 2014, giving honor for her life as well. Goddess. The way she prayed and swayed, inspiration from the floorboard stretching all the way up to heaven. She was the sweet sound of victory in a world that never quite made sense. Love, peace, hope, justice, flowing with Jesus and following Jesus, her closest friend. I remember the African garb she would wear, royalty, not just to me, but the entire community. I follow in her footsteps, not just following in her footsteps day to day, but every day, moment to moment. And I realize I am indeed my God's mothers, aunties, sisters, grandmothers, and great, great, greats. Yeah, they were great. I am their dream come true, the fulfillment of a legacy that lets my little light shine through. As a blues woman of new, I never can forget the way she prayed down the Spirit from heaven. Holy Ghost power that you could not deny. Holy Ghost power that tingle in your spine, that focus in your mind, that presence that lets you know the Spirit is here and alive. Amens from the choir in the burgundy and off-white robes. Brother such and such and so and so with his wide eyes closed. Sister such and such singing, somebody prayed for me. Had me on their mind. Mother over in the front, standing and clapping, standing and snapping with her peppered hair. Some folks look like track stars running around the church because God had been just that good to them. Purple and red or white being placed over women passed out in the Spirit, sealing the moment with a prayer by some other auntie in the church. I knew better than other folks, see? The women trusted me with their secrets. They trusted me with the hard truth, see? That's how I learned so early to be trustworthy, authentic, caring, kind, devoted. That's how I learned how to pray. They said, baby, stay in your word. Be in it, not of it, this world. They said, no boys and no babies. Remember God's word. Eat your greens. Wear your good shoes on Sunday. Always follow your heart. They said, you, my dear, are a work of art. That's how I made it to where I am today. Preaching and teaching and treating people real good and stuff. Remember me? Do Lord, oh, do Lord, oh, do you remember me? Who would I be without them? God's body on earth. She is on earth. You are on earth. We are on earth. God is. Happy Mother's Day, family. The scripture meditation. All glory to God forever and ever. Amen. Galatians 1:5, New Living Translation.
Good morning. My name is Minister Eric Toodles from the Presbyterian Church of St. Albans. I greet you on this Mother's Day, wishing all the mothers, grandmothers, the aunties, the sisters, those that are mentoring mothers, those that are spiritual mothers, I wish you a happy Mother's Day on this Sunday morning as we celebrate you on this day. And I wish and hope that your day is full of joy, full of love, and full of family connections. Now, I greet you, good morning, to children of God, especially the saints of the Presbyterian Church of St. Albans, Springfield Garden Presbyterian Church, Hollis Presbyterian Church, Through Memorial Presbyterian Church, Westminster Presbyterian Church in Cedar Manor, First Presbyterian Church in Far Rockaway, First Presbyterian Church in Jamaica, and Dunton Presbyterian Church. Our call to worship. The grace and the peace of the risen Lord be with you all. I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord, for here we are, families together, young and old alike. Here we are, this sacred place to celebrate God's gift of grace. God is our true parent, our father and mother. Let us worship the Lord in gladness, in prayer, in song, and through God's holy word. Amen. Our hymn of praise is Faith of Our Mothers, sung to the tune of Faith of Our Fathers. And after that, the next voice you will hear will be that of Minister Virginia Richbourgh, who will do the Mother's Day prayer of invocation, confession, and the assurance of pardon.
Good morning, church family. Today, Sunday, May 9th, 2021, at the St. Albans Presbyterian Church, under the leadership of our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Edward Davis, we say welcome and happy Mother's Day. Let us now take our hymns, our hymnal, and open to our song, our hymn of praise this morning, Faith of Our Mothers Living Still, in cradle song and bedtime prayer. In nursery love and fireside love, thy presence still pervades the air. Faith of our mothers, living faith. We will be true to thee till death.
Good morning, family of God. My name is Minister Virginia Richbourgh of the Presbyterian Church of St. Albans. On this special day, from within these sacred walls, may I wish all daughters of God abundant blessings for this happy Mother's Day, today and every day. Whether you are a mother, a grandmother, big sister, or an auntie, a godmother, a surrogate mother, or a right on time step-in mother, rest assured beyond any shadow of a doubt that Abba God sees us, hears us, and is mindful of each labor of love, the originator and perfecter of the faith which anchors our lives, says to each and every one of us individually, well done, my good and faithful daughters. Be continually blessed. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, please join me in the prayer of invocation, confession, and the assurance of pardon. Please join me in the prayer. Loving God, our Father and Mother, we thank you for adopting us into your family through the miracle of your grace. Thank you for the sacrifice of your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you, omnipotent God, for calling us into your family as brothers and sisters. Today, loving God, we pray for the mothers, grandmothers, aunties, and all who are mother substitutes and surrogates. We pray for those who cared for us when we were helpless, who comforted us when we were hurt, whose love and care we too often took for granted. Today, we pray for those who are grieving the loss of their mother, for those who never knew their biological mothers and are longing for her, for those who have experienced the wonder of an adopted mother's love, for those families separated by death, divorce, and conflict. Oh Lord, grant them your special blessing. We confess our need of always being cleansed by having a forgiving spirit. Keep us united with you and with each other so that we can be and become all that you, Almighty God, meant for us to be while we were yet in our mother's womb. O Lord most holy, we thank you for the blessing of forgiveness and for the assurance that if we ask anything according to your perfect will and in the name of Jesus, it will be given us. On this special day, may we leave this place knowing that you are both willing and able to help us forgive, forget, and move forward in the name of Jesus. Amen. After a moment of silent reflections on mothers of all generations, the Lord's Prayer will be lifted by Benjamin Campbell.
Good morning. My name is Benjamin Campbell. Let us recite the prayer that the Lord taught to his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Is there anybody here who loves my Jesus? Anybody here? Thank you.
Good morning and happy Mother's Day to all the mothers in our congregation and in our church and in the collaborative churches. Happy Mother's Day. It seems like on Mother's Day, we like to think about the mothers that we have come across in our lives or in the Bible. And one of the mothers that comes to my mind is found in the book of 2 Samuel. And her name is Rizpah. And Rizpah's story you can read later on today. But she is an example of all the mothers that stood vigil for their children. Mothers are very persistent. Mothers will not give up. And even though this Rizpah suffered a tragedy, she did not give up. So read her story in 2 Samuel 21. Now let us pray the prayer for all people. As we lift up the body of Christ in prayer, we make special intercession for the saints in the Presbyterian churches of Southeast Queens. This morning we lift up prayers for Sadie Morris, Tawana Hammond, and the Hollis Presbyterian Church family. We lift up our prayers for the Presbyterian Church of St. Albans. We lift up our senior pastor, Reverend Ed Davis, his wife, Helen Davis, and the entire congregation in prayer. And we ask a special anointing upon Elders George Addison, John Efferson, Mildred Tipton, Judy Toodles, the sister of Minister Eric Toodles, as well as Sister Taylor Telford. I ask you to keep in prayer my beloved wife, Blanche Smith, and me, Pastor Weldon Smith. We all need prayer for healing. We also ask the Lord to shower his comfort and peace on Deacon Gregson Smith and his family in the loss of their father. We ask blessings on the First Presbyterian Church of Far Rockaway family, for Elder Dr. Florence Okpala, Elder Hazel Adams, Sister Pauline Mortimer, Sister Lovely, Sister Delrose Brown, and the entire family and friends of Throop Memorial Presbyterian Church. Please keep in prayer our Sister Earlene Johnson Boyd, Elder Ann Murphy, Deacon Lena Hunter, and Sister Linda Williams, and the entire Springfield Gardens Church family. Please, Holy Father, we ask you to bless the Westminster Presbyterian Church family. Please grant grace and favor to Reverend Patrick O'Connor and the First Presbyterian Church in Jamaica family, and also your continued blessings on Reverend Deswick Brown and the entire Dunton Presbyterian Church family. And now let us lift up our prayers for all people and all the churches. Most holy and gracious God, we thank you, Father, that your love is enduring and ever replenished every day. We thank you that in you there is no failure. And we thank you, Father, that you will put your hands on our family. We thank you, Father, that you hold families and you hold our friends and You hold our loved ones under your wings of protection. We thank you, Father, that you stand watch over us the long night, and you stand watch over us the long day. You're with us as we go out. You're with us as we come in. You're with us as we rise up, and you're with us as we lie down. We thank you, Father, that you, dear Lord God, have so blessed us that the guardian angels encamp round about our families and round about our neighbors and round about our churches. We thank you, Father, that you, dear Lord, will soon end this virus that has separated us, that we don't touch each other physically, but virtually. And we praise your name that the church is ever vigilant and ever powerful and even goes on in the middle of pandemics. So we pray, Father God Almighty, that you will send the guardian angels to watch over our families, our churches, and each one of us. Have mercy upon us, Lord God. Keep us free from all evil. Keep us free from violent men, women, and children, and animals. In Jesus Christ's name, amen and amen. The next voice you hear will be Jaden Smith as he announces selections. God bless you, church family.
My name is Jaden Smith, and I will be reading the Old Testament, Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5.
My name is Justin Smith, and I will be reading God's Holy Word, which comes from the New Testament books of Galatians chapter 1, verse 5, and 1 John chapter 2, verse 20.
Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5 says, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you. I ordained you a prophet to the nations."
Galatians chapter 1, verse 5. "To whom be glory forever and ever. Amen." 1 John chapter 2, verse 20. "But you have an anointing from the Holy One, and you know all things." Please join us in the sermonic selection, "A Song for Mama," by the Presbyterian Church of St. Albans Sunday School Choir. Following, we will have the sermon, "Thank You, Mother, Anointed and Appointed," by Reverend Dr. Edward Davis of the Presbyterian Church of St. Albans.
"Her children arise and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many women do noble things, but you, dear mother, excel them all."
You tell me everything and everything you give me. I was deep inside. You're the driving force in my life. Oh yeah. There isn't anything or anyone that I could be, and it just wouldn't feel right if I didn't have you by my side.
No one else can be what you have been to me. You'll always be. There were so many times looking back when I was so afraid. And then you come to me and then you say to me, I can't face anything. And no one else can do what you have done for me. You'll always be, you will always be the girl in my life. Ooh.
Mama.
Because she comforts me and gives me the things that I want.
I love my mom because she cares for me.
I love my mom because she made me the good boy that I am today.
I love my mom because she understands me and feels it all my life.
Good morning, Presbyterian Churches of St. Albans, the collaborative churches which have been working so diligently to keep the Word of God going forth in our churches and our community. I know God is proud of all of you who've worked so diligently to see the Word of God go forth. So proud of all of the churches that have seen, even though the doors have been closed, the doors of the hearts and the minds of our church people have been opened. So we give God praise and honor, and we thank God for this Mother's Day. Thank God for the mothers who've suffered and worked so hard to make a way for our children. We love you, mothers. We thank you, mothers, and the fathers who've worked so diligently. Let us open with a word of prayer. Let us pray. Almighty and loving God, we thank you for this day, the day which you have made. Today, Almighty God, that you've allowed us to come to celebrate in so many, many ways. We come this morning to celebrate mothers. The wonderful mothers and grandmothers and great-grandmothers and those surrogate mothers who have been so wonderful in the world helping and raising your children. So, Father, as we bring this word this morning, a word entitled, Thank You, Mothers, Anointed and Appointed, let a word of love, a word of inspiration, a word of encouragement flow into the hearts of our dear, lovely mothers and all of our members, all wonderful people who are joining in this church service on this morning. May God bless us and keep us in your perfect peace. Amen. Good morning once again. I'm so grateful to be in the pulpit. I've been out for quite a while, recovering from that accident. But God has been good and gracious, and I thank him. I'd like to share a homily this morning entitled, Thank You, Mothers, Anointed and Appointed. Thank you, mothers, anointed and appointed. Hear the word coming from Jeremiah 1 and 5. Before I formed you in my womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. I appointed you as a prophet to the nations. And we're going to read from 1 John 2, verse 20. But you have an anointing from the Holy One, and all of you know the truth that God brings forth. Once again, we are grateful to be in the church once again. And on this Mother's Day, we come to celebrate this Mother's Day on this glorious day of May 9th, 2020. Thomas Woodrow Wilson, in the 28th President of the United States, on May 9th, 1914, signed a proclamation declaring that the second Sunday in May would be considered as Mother's Day. We thank you for the wisdom and the knowledge of a dear sister by the name of Anne Marie Jarvis, who so diligently in wanting to celebrate and elevate and thank mothers for all that they have done. So we thank God for this Mother's Day occurrence. Many of us have already bought some gifts and greeting cards and ordered some cakes and flowers and planned to perhaps go out at one point to have a meal with your mother and to express your love to her, celebrating Mother's Day. COVID-19 has already interrupted some of your plans, but thanks be to God, you're going to love that mother in the way that God has ascribed you to love. A mother, we love you. We thank you, mothers, for all you've done and all that you're going to do in the lives of your children, your grandchildren, and those around you. My message this morning is thank you, mothers, anointed and appointed. Thank you, mothers, anointed and appointed. Anointed is defined as one who's consecrated, set aside, or ordained and blessed by God to care for and minister to others, an anointed one. I believe every mother is anointed by God and appointed by God to walk in motherhood. As reflected on my mother, I am so grateful that she was such a wonderful and dynamic woman of God. My mother was so spiritual, hallelujah, and that spirit flowed through all of her seven children. Now I understand that the consecrated life is a life that's set aside, holy, and loving God. And my mother had a consecrated life, like I know so many of you mothers on the TV program today or the filming program today or however you're seeing us today. Thank God for the consecrated life that God put within you. My mother was so consecrated and so blessed and so anointed and so loving. She attended quite a few churches, the AME Church, the Baptist Church, the Presbyterian Church, the Pentecostal Church. Church was church for her because she knew that the love of God was coming and going through all of the various churches. So I thank my mother for all that she did and has done in our lives. I remember as a child, we constantly prayed and sang spiritual songs together every Sunday. And I'm grateful for my mother who instilled Jesus in us at a very young age. Thanks to an anointed life, my mother had seven children. And I'm glad to say that three of them are now pastors and the other four attend church regularly when the doors are open. I want you to understand that I am not saying every woman who is a mother walks in an anointing. We know that that's the case. But I believe that God gives an anointing specialty to women who will open up their hearts and say, yes, God, use me, help me, direct me, and guide me. I believe that the angels of these anointed mothers, her personal angels, and well, all the angels will be there with those women and direct those women and guide those women out of the valleys of darkness and despair and heartache and whatever. We are grateful the Lord God is always there with diligent mothers seeking to do his will. Thank you, mothers. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your inspiration. Thank you for your caring. Thank you for all that you've done to rear your children, not only your children, children in the community and children that were neighbors. My mother was like many mothers. She was a prayer warrior, and all seven of her children, thanks be to God, are in the church, surrounded by God's love. Three of my brothers and sisters are ministers, and the others are very diligent workers in the church when the doors are open. So we thank you, mothers, for what you have done, and I thank our mother for what she has done. Our mother's prayer opened doors that could be closed. That's what the prayer of mothers do. They open doors. With a certainty, her prayers went up to heaven, and we were sick. Her prayers comforted us, and we were hurting. And when we were in confusion, we know that the prayers of a mother go very far. And I thank God for our personal mother. The word of the Lord tells us that God will keep you in perfect peace as you keep your mind stayed on the Lord. Trust in the Lord Jehovah, because in the Lord Jehovah is everlasting strength. That's one of the Psalms, one of the words, Isaiah 26, 3 and 4, that our mother helped to instill within us. Thank you, mothers, for instilling the word of God in your children. I can remember whenever I found myself in a distressful situation, depressed, or faced with a problem, it's very strange, and I know it's the anointing of the God, but my mother would call and pray with me and pray with all of my brothers and sisters. She was an anointed woman. And I thank God for you women out there with that same spirit of being anointed and appointed to pray for and to love your children and your neighbors. And I could say that the prayers of an anointed mother availeth much. I can say that. I know that. And for many mothers within the church, I know that your prayers availeth much. So keep on praying, mothers of all the churches, the seven churches. Mothers, keep praying, because God hears your prayers, and the prayers of the righteous availeth much. I'm a living witness that prayer changes things. A living witness that prayer changes things. I'm certain that many of your testimonies will be similar to mine. If your mother had given up on you, like most mothers don't, but my testimony is that my mother did not give up. My mother was there all of the time. I'm fortunate to say that this morning, that when I had accepted Jesus as my Savior, the words that my mother had shared with us on many occasions, Romans 10, 9 through 10, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus Christ and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. I'm grateful that my mother helped us to confess. I'm grateful that our mother helped us to know about Jesus. I'm grateful that our mother prayed with us. Not somebody prayed with us, but our mothers prayed with us. You see, I've always seen the goodness of a strong mother and one that loves the Lord. Not only was my mother a strong woman in my life, there's a sister by the name of Jerry Haynes. She was a wonderful prayer warrior. And we prayed every night together with an anointed and an appointing and seeking God. We prayed not only for ourselves, for those that we worked with. We prayed not for those that we worked with. We prayed for the world. And this sister really helped to strengthen me. Thank you, strong mothers. Thank you, strong sisters. Thank you, strong grandmothers and aunts who've been there praying with your children, praying with your neighbors, praying with those who are in trouble. The prayers of a righteous woman availeth much. And we thank you from the bottom of our hearts for what you have done. Anointed mothers are here today. I would like to thank you, anointed mothers, for the comforting, for the counseling, for the enabling, for the assistance, for the joy that you brought to the hearts of so many people. Thank you, mothers. We thank God for the anointed. We thank God for the anointed and appointed mothers. And mothers, you are anointed and been appointed by God to do special works. From the time of creation, God has anointed the woman to be the bearer of life, the giver of life, the sustainer of life, and carrying life. Not just physically, but emotionally and spiritually. Thank God for you mothers, for all that God has implanted within you. The mother is the one who imparts the emotional, the spiritual, and the dedication into our hearts. We thank God for the mothers who've been there keeping us and guiding us, instructing us, and watching over us. We praise God for their strength and for their goodness. The life that mothers give is just unbelievable. I'd like to just think a little bit about the anointing. I believe that the anointing that mothers have comes directly from the realms of God. There's something within our mothers that help us to know that they are special, the children that they rear, the children that they love, the children that they encourage. Thank you, mothers. From the bottom of our hearts, we appreciate you. Thank you, mothers, for all that you do and all that you will be doing in the lives of your children around us. I'd like to share some thoughts about the mothers. We thank you, mothers, for being anointed mothers who are the givers of life. We thank you, dear women, because God placed within you a special love and direction and understanding of your children. So we thank you, mothers, for your anointing that has moved and saved and helped and delivered children. We thank you, mothers, for the anointing in you that's been a blessing down through the ages. I would like to take a few moments and thank the mothers who stayed awake during the night because their child was sick and they prayed. I would like to thank those mothers who went to our schools to keep us on the right track. I would like to thank those mothers who made delicious meals for us from early times of all the goodies that they did. Thank you, mothers. I would like to thank the mothers and grandmothers who sacrificed for us to get us an education and to go to college and to be something. My parents said, I want you to be somebody. And my mother worked hard that her children might advance and be somebody in God's eyesight. I would like to thank those mothers who got up early, prepared for us to go to school, and then went to do their daily work, and many of them being domestic. My mother and my mama were domestic workers, but they were domestic workers during the day, but they were loving mothers during the evening. And I thank you, my mother, and all the mothers who've been so industrious in making certain that their children would be treated right and would hopefully go to college or go to school and turn out to be a blessing to the family. I would like to thank those mothers for the love she gave to and never stopped loving, no matter what went wrong or what went down. We thank God for the mothers who worked and loved and spoke truth into us. I would like to thank those mothers for your kind words when my words were not kind and not proper for to speak. I would like to thank those mothers who led us to God and prayed until a change came into our hearts. I'd like to just thank those mothers. Thank you, mothers, for the love that a mother and a mother only can give. Thank you, mother, for the discipline that stopped us from going and doing the wrong things in the wrong places. Thank you for the kind words that you as a mother spoke to us and lifted us up and blessed us when others might not have. Thank you, mothers, for being so kind and so generous. Thanks for all the prayers that you saw us through, all the times that you were there enabling us and lifting us up. All we can say is we thank you, mother. We thank you, mother. We thank you, mother. I'm thankful for my mother. And I wish I could tell her what I've seen in her and how she blessed us. She's gone on to glory, but her words and her teachings are still within our hearts. If your mother's still alive, no matter how many times they have gotten on your nerves, take time to call your mother. Take time to encourage your mother. Take time to thank your mother. Don't just give them a card or a bush of flowers, but give them your own words that will bless their souls. Tell them from the bottom of your heart what you mean. If your mother is in heaven, call the person that stood in her place when you were in need of someone standing there. Let them know that you are thankful for what they did for you while your mother was alive. So I'm so grateful for mothers. We love you, mothers. We thank you, mothers. We adore you, mothers. We bow down before you, mothers. We're thankful. There's a song, Amen, by Boys to Men, which has blessed my heart. And I'd like to close with the thoughts coming from it. And you heard it, but it says, Mama, Mama, You know I love you. Oh, you know I love you. Mama, Mama, you're the queen of my heart. Your love is like tears from the stars. Mama, I just want you to know, loving you is like food to my soul. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Oh, yes, it is. Yes, it is, oh, Mother. Loving you is like food to my soul. You've always done for me. You've always been around for me. Even when I was bad, you showed me right from wrong. Yes, you did. And you took up for me when everyone was downing me. You always did understand. You gave me the strength to go on. There, amen, is no one like you, Mother. There were so many times, looking back, when I was afraid. And then you came to me to say to me, I can face anything. Mothers, thank you for encouraging us. Mothers, thank you for loving us. Mothers, thank you for embracing us. The words go on to say, you'll always be the girl in my life. Mama, Mama, you know I love you. Oh, you know I love you. Mama, Mama, queen of my heart. That is so uplifting. I pray that your mother, that you reflect upon your mother being the queen of your heart. Your love is like tears from the stars. Your love is like tears from the stars. Mama, I just want you to know, I just want you to know, loving you is like food to my soul. Never going to go a day without you. Fill me up just thinking about you. I'll never go a day without you, Mama. Mama, Mama, you know I love you. Mama, Mama, you're the queen of my heart. Your love is like tears from the stars. Mama, I just want you to know, loving you is like food for my soul. Loving you, Mama, and all that you've done is more than food for my soul. Oh yes, you are the food of my soul. Yes, Mama. Mama, Mama, we love you. And we thank you, mothers, for what you have done. We thank you, mothers, for what you're going to do. And we thank you, mothers, for God's grace and healing and love and power surround you. And we thank you, daddies, for loving your wife and the mother of your children. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May his face shine upon you. And may you realize that we must thank our mothers because they are anointed and they are appointed by God to be special vessels of honor. Thank you, mothers. Amen and amen. all the mothers and grandmothers and surrogate mothers, to all the brothers and sisters, to all those who've heard the word today of thanking your mother because she's anointed and appointed. She, the women, have a special connection with God and a connection that brings them close. So we know mothers, and many mothers, know the Lord Jesus Christ. But if you're here on this Mother's Day, mother, man, woman, boy, or girl, and you do not know Christ as your personal Savior, the Bible says, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any person will open up their heart's door, I'll come in and sup with them. I'll come in and bless them. I'll come in and make them. I'll come in and assure them that absent from the body, when we leave this earth, can be present before the Lord. Yes, God wants to save you. Yes, God wants to heal you. Yes, God wants to bless you. And yes, God wants you to find a church. I pray that you will ask God to direct you in a Bible-believing church. I pray that you will ask God to open up your hearts on this Mother's Day, knowing that your mother, if she's gone on to glory, in her own sweet way, praying and thinking and loving you. So may God bless you and keep you. May God save you. Let us close this thought by praying the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'll fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy, my angels will follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. May God bless you and keep you and watch over you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, the Reverend Dr. Edward Davis, for the wonderful sermon this day on Mother's Day. Now I extend the invitation to you. Our invitational hymn is Rise Up. Rise Me Up. It's a duet with Samuel Clark and Erica Liburd.
Thank you. Church family. My name is Angie Bujeke of the Presbyterian Church of St. Albans. We will now be reaffirming our faith through the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and seated on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We will now be having the Gloria Patri.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen.
Here are our announcements for this Sunday morning. The Presbyterian Church of St. Albans has a Sunday school each Sunday morning at 9:30 a.m. The Zoom meeting ID number is 876-450-4356. The passcode is 695634. Once again, the Zoom meeting ID is 876-450-4356. The passcode 695634. We want to thank everyone who is faithful in their giving to their local congregations, either by mail or by in person or online. Please continue to give your offerings to your church. As it says in 2 Corinthians 9:7. So let us give as they purpose in their life, not grudgingly or out of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. Also, the prayer line is now open to receive your requests and testimonies. But you can also call the prayer line Monday through Friday, from 12:30 p.m. to 2 p.m. by dialing 712-770-5505, access code 293-822-549, # Remember, the number is 712-770-5505, access code 293-822-549, # Hollis Presbyterian Church also has a prayer line Monday through Saturday at 7:15 p.m. The phone number is 508-924-5361. And there is no access code. A number, again, for the Hollis Presbyterian Prayer Line, 508-924-5361.
Like this. we need the Savior in times like this. We need
by the Reverend Dr. Everett Davis.
Let us now recite the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord be gracious unto you and keep you and watch over you and direct you in all that you do, now, henceforth, and forevermore. And the threefold Amen. 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 And Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
What do you do when you've done all you can and it seems like it's never enough? Seems like you can't begin. Now you
my mother pray for me. She had me on her mind, took the time to pray for me. I'm so glad she prayed. I'm so glad she prayed. I'm so glad she prayed for me. My sister prayed for me. She had me on her mind, took the time to pray for me. I'm so glad she prayed. I'm so glad she prayed. I'm so glad she prayed for me. My grandma prayed for me, had me on her mind, took the time to pray for me. I'm so glad she prayed. I'm so glad she prayed.